Deputy O'Brien.
To understand the programme for government, you promised to, and I quote, increase the stock of social housing. But this morning and every morning, we hear the real human stories of families left by this government and the previous government languishing on the housing waiting list. Mothers struggling to feed their children and to pay their bills because they're being forced to live in poor quality and overpriced rental accommodation. The number of people on local authority housing lists continue to rise. The figures now touching 112,000 families on waiting lists throughout the state. Meanwhile, 3,500 council houses lie idle. In my own city of Cork, almost 8,000 families are on the housing waiting list, with a stock of 500 houses lying idle. And the number of people dependent on rent supplement is continuing to rise, and the cuts to that rent supplement are forcing more and more people into financial hardship and in some cases into homelessness. Homeless charities are reporting a significant increase in the number of people using their services, and Taoiseach, the reason for this is very simple. Your government, like the Fianna Fáil government before you, is slashing the budget for social housing. You have no plan to address the housing crisis in this state. Since you took office, Taoiseach, this government has cut the funding for social housing by more than half. That is why the waiting lists continue to grow. So, Taoiseach, when will you honour the programme for government commitment to start investing in social housing and to address the housing crisis?
Thank you, Deputy. Taoiseach.
Well, first of all, approximately 5,000 additional social housing units will be provided in 2014. This will include new build, units leased from the not-for-profit sector and general leasing. We're also on track to secure 500 social housing units from NAMA this year, and will deliver 2,000 social housing units through NAMA throughout the lifetime of the government. In the recent budget, we returned, albeit on a modest scale, to mainstream housing construction, and this is an issue that I hope we will be able to expand on as the country's finances improve. The recent budget contained an additional €30 million for social housing construction and refurbishment. Approximately 50% of this additional investment will be dedicated to bringing long-term vacant units back into use in 2014. It's estimated that more than 300 units will benefit from this dedicated fund, and in the coming weeks, local authorities will be asked to submit specific properties for investment. There is a problem in relation to vacant housing stock. About 3% of the local authority housing stock is vacant. Now, this includes what would normally be called the kind of the natural turnover that arises at any time when tenancies end and a new tenancy is to be appointed. There are, however, a number of local authority dwellings that are vacant for an unacceptably long period of time. Those are issues that have to be dealt with. I would hope that local authorities, with the resources that is being provided for in the budget, will get to grips with that problem, and that we won't see the continuing problem of dwellings lying idle for a very long period of time, which you know, is a waste in terms of the fact that there are people who are on housing lists who could well be using them. Is obviously a loss of revenue for the local authority concerned, and in many cases is a problem for local communities where boarded up dwellings constitute something of an eyesore.
Deputy O'Brien.
Just going on the figures you provided there, we're looking at probably an additional 7,500 units over the lifetime of this government. Now, we have a housing list of 112,000 families, so it's a drop in the ocean. And announcing £15 million here and £15 million there is just not going to compensate for the massive cuts that this government has overseen. £233 million cut from the capital budget in terms of housing, and you're talking about £30 million. It's just not good enough, Taoiseach. The reality is, the figures speak for themselves, and this government has abandoned those on social housing lists who are the most vulnerable in society, Tánaiste. So what outline, please, for us and for those people and those families who are waiting for adequate housing and social housing lists, what is the long-term plan of this government? Because 15 million here and 15 million there just doesn't cut it. I'm over it, Minister, and so are those families.
Thank you, Tánaiste.
Well, I don't know if you missed it, but the country was broke. The country ran out of money, Deputy, at the end of 2010. And this government has had to restore the country's finances. Now, we're in the fortunate position now, as we speak now, that we have done that, that we're about to exit from the bailout. This government has not abandoned the issue of social housing. Far, far, far from it. To date, as I've said, for 2014, there's to be 5,000 additional social housing units provided. In the additional funding has been provided in this year's budget to recommence housing construction. As I've said, it is intended that as the finances of the country improve, that we will improve on that. In addition to the construction of houses, we've also committed to the upgrading of the energy efficiency of existing local authority dwellings. 25,000 local authority dwellings will be affected by that and be upgraded in that programme. 4,000 of those have been upgraded in the first 4 months of the programme already, and we're going to continue with that. We're very much aware,
thank you,
very aware of the numbers of people who are on housing lists, of their housing needs, and now that we have got ourselves to a situation where we have stabilised the country's finances, moving out of the bailout, we have signalled very clearly in this year's budget that social housing and the provision of social housing is something that we are addressing and will continue to address.
Deputy Healy.